pew to the side here, just in case there was an emergency. Those are the exits to the room. And out of courtesy to those around you and to recipients this evening, please silence your cell phones. Tonight, 56 members of the class of 2016 are scheduled to receive awards. I'm pleased to announce that there are 62 local organizations, clubs, individuals, and scholarship trust funds are giving financial awards in the amount of $122,490 to Wellsville High School seniors who are planning to continue their education. Thank you to all those generous individuals, clubs, and associations who have invested in our students' futures. Year after year, this community has demonstrated that it values education, cares about our students, and is willing to commit words to action on behalf of our students. Thank you to all those who support. Thank you for all the support you provide to our students here at Wellsville High School. At the conclusion of our awards ceremony this evening, everyone is invited to a reception, which will be held on a second floor atrium. Now it's time for the awards. Presenters, when I call your name or introduce you, please come to the stage, and Mrs. Braunschweiler will give you an envelope which has your scholarship recipient's name printed on the front. After the presentation of each award, we would like both the presenter and student to exit the stage to the right for photos that will be displayed later on our district's webpage. Our first award this evening is presented by Mr. Brian Gray, the Wellsville High School Alumni Association. Mr. Gray, would you please come to the stage?
Administration, parents, students, grandparents, guests, whoever here. I'm always pleased to come up here and do this every year. Not every year, but most of them. This year's going to be a little bit different than what we've done in the past. The Alumni Association, all the money is donated to the association by alumnus. And so far this year, we have presented $63,900 in scholarships. The winners are this year, Leah Christman. Come on. James Ender. Amy Lushbrow. And Emily Willard. This next award, I'm very sad to do, but I'm also very, very pleased to do, that the alumni board this short while ago lost one of its members from, he's been a member for 30 plus years, and that's the sad part. But the happy part of me is that I'm going to present a scholarship in his name, Gary Havens, to his grandson, Gary Havens Jr.
Please welcome to the stage Mr. Josh Ormsby from the Allegheny County Pomona Grange number 45 to present Perseverance Awards.
Good evening. On behalf of Allegheny County Grange, I commend the class of 2016 on your hard work and determination to reach graduation and the completion of this part of your journey. The Grange has long recognized the importance of education for all in its many forms. Some students face physical, mental, and emotional challenges, while others are confronted with environmental, social, or family issues. In the Grange, we are taught that difficulties are opportunities to test our abilities and to persevere. The first honoree tonight is an inspiration by working hard and meeting the goal of getting a CDOS credential. An inspirational award is presented to Shawnee Ives. Diploma. This Perseverance Award is presented to Haley Cook.
Parker Family Scholarship will be presented tonight by Mr. Paul Parker.
Good evening. I'm Paul Parker, Wellsville High School class of 1978. I'm here representing the Parker family, most notably my mom and dad, Dick and Shirley Parker, who created this scholarship a few years back. It's always been very important to my dad, and it's got higher relevance this year because we lost dad last week. The purpose of this scholarship is to find a student with the ambition and the ability to further his education or her education, but just maybe needs a little help with funding. Or as dad would say, we want to help those who really want to help themselves. I understand that we've found somebody this year that fits that profile. So. Some of the comments that I've heard attributed to this year's recipient, a hard worker, a winner, someone who does everything with a desire to succeed, a high character kid, just to name a few. So with that, the Parkers are very pleased to award this year's scholarship to Cooper Buckley.
The Kenneth Kiefer Senior Memorial Award will be presented tonight by Mrs. Shelley Chafee, Mr. Kiefer's daughter.
Class of 82, thank you. Congratulations, first of all, to all the recipients tonight. Certainly your hard work and determination shows throughout the year and certainly tonight. The Ken Kiefer Senior Memorial Award is now in its 35th year. It honors a male and female member of the senior class who demonstrate leadership and service to the school and their community. The criterion that the committee uses is the participation in various clubs and organizations, athletic teams, academic achievement, and an officer leadership roles during the year. This person could also be considered a very well-rounded person. The recipients' names are engraved on a plaque in the guidance office, and I'm pleased to announce the winners of the Kenneth E. Kiefer Senior Memorial Award are Riley Hoffman, and there's ties for the boys because I could not choose between these two, Cooper Buckley and Mike Giopoulos.
Thank you. The Walker Business Service Scholarship is presented this evening by Mrs. Bonnie Walker, owner of Walker Business and Staffing.
First, I'd like to congratulate the class of 2016 and wish you the best of luck in the next chapter of your life. And I, too, am from the class of 1978. Each year, Walker Business gives a scholarship to a student who will be furthering their education in business or entrepreneurship. We don't just consider the students' grades, but their community service. Because as most of you know, if you're in business for yourself or work for a business, you need to give back to the community. I've had the pleasure of working with this young lady several times. She has volunteered her time for several years, probably totaling over 1,000 hours of community service. And I feel she's a great role model for the youth. I'd like to present my award to Liz Cole.
Please welcome to the podium, Ms. Michelle Elbert.
Good evening. The David Mallory Memorial Scholarship is a memorial fund which honors hardworking graduates who plan to further their education. This year's winners are Tyler Brandis, Ryan Dunham, James Emser, Piscatelli, and Justin Spinelli. The next award for this evening is the Pete Childs Memorial Fisher's Pharmacy Scholarship. Fisher's Pharmacy generously recognizes graduates who plan a career in pharmacy, medical health, or have a love of music. And this year's recipient of the Pete Childs Memorial Fisher's Pharmacy Scholarship is Tyler Anderson.
Please welcome Mrs. Lindsay McNich, school counselor of the high school.
This school year, we experienced a horrific tragedy when one of our recent graduates lost his life in a car accident. Dylan Mitchell was a student who was very dear to my heart and impacted many people in our community. He may have had a big, tough exterior, but he was a gentleman at heart. When his mom called and asked me to present this scholarship, I was truly touched because Dylan is a student who represents grit and perseverance. Even when classes were challenging for him, Dylan refused to give up. Watching Dylan walk across the stage and receive his high school diploma was genuinely one of my proudest graduation moments to date. Dylan's family felt very strongly about their choice for this year's scholarship. The student chosen is kind, respectful, honest, and hardworking, all qualities that we appreciated about Dylan. I am honored to present Austin Crawford with the first annual Dylan Mitchell Scholarship.
Patrick Gosley Memorial Scholarship will be presented this evening by Ms. Lori Gosley Hackett, Pat's sister.
Thank you so much. It's such an honor to be here with everyone else, and I'm proud to say I also am a member of the class of 1978 with Paul Parker and Bonnie, and of course Mrs. Brunchidle. It's really an honor to be here and present the first Patrick Gosley Memorial Scholarship. Pat is my brother, and there are six kids in our family, and we lost him sadly and very unexpectedly in January. Pat loved Wellsville High School so much. He had such energy for school. It was really a wonderful time for him. He was committed so much to his friends, to his school, and to his family. So we were really excited to pause now to provide the first scholarship in his name. So it's my pleasure to announce the winner of the first, which will be one of many, Pat Gosley Memorial Scholarship to Emily Willard.
The Shane Colligan Memorial Scholarship and Variety Club of Buffalo Scholarship is presented this evening by Mr. Tim Colligan, Shane Colligan's father.
So must be you got to know somebody, because my cousin Lori got ahead of me this year. How about that? Okay. It's, that they honored Pat was just a wonderful idea, and I thank them for that. Shane Colligan Scholarship. We've been doing this since Shane passed away in 2003. Shane, everybody knows Shane. Shane was full of life, and he loved his education. And when he passed away just 50 days shy of his graduation at St. Bonaventure, it was so sad, obviously, for the family, but he culminated his educational career. They did honor his award, his diploma, and it wasn't just, I think, days after that that my comrades from the American Legion authorized the sponsorship of the first Shane Colligan Scholarship, and I can't thank you guys enough for doing that, and they've continued to do so in these years past. So the Shane Colligan Scholarship, sponsored by or funded by the American Legion, is going to go to a young man who I cannot say enough about. He's been my right arm doing the Variety Club telethon phone set in the last 2 years, and I think he helped before that as his brother did too, so their family comes from a long line of helping us, and I can't thank them enough. So, Johnny Piscatelli, come on up. The next few scholarships I have to offer, my wife and I, in conjunction with the Variety Club, Wellsville Satterlite, over the years, we've looked at the students who kind of would be reminiscent of what Shane was. Personality, go-getter, and we had a number of them this year. And to you students, I congratulate you, and I only wish that we could give more money to this, because what you need to take out of this night when you go out of here is not the amount of money that you get, but the fact that you were recognized by some organization means that you were a standout to be recognized, and for that you should be proud of yourself. So we have a few scholarships for the Variety Club in Shane's name, and I would ask Bridget Christman, Leah Christman, Sarah Dunhoff, Grace Irway, Christina Good, a little bit out of order here, Sarah Stevens, and John Piscatelli again.
Please welcome Mr. Lyle Ostrander and Mr. Chris Carr to present the Morrison Hayes American Legion Post 702 Scholarships and Oratorical Award.
I would like to thank the graduates of the class of 2016 and all the candidates that applied for our award this year. The Morrison Hayes Scholarship, the American Legion Post 702, within the direction of our commander, Brent Roberts. Candidates were scored on several categories, which included our core values of leadership, honor, athleticism, Americanism, integrity, volunteer effort to the school and community, as well as academics and military heritage. Our three winners tonight include top 10 in the class of 2016, as well as the children and grandchildren of military veterans. Their award, an amount of $1,000, are as follows. Leah Christman. Austin Crawford. And Dylan Griffiths. Legion for several years now is sponsored by the Oratorical Contest, and this year's winner won at the county level, as in every level they make it, the largest scholarship we'll be able to award to them. This year's winner will receive $500, Danielle Guilford.
Please welcome to the podium Mr. Brian Myers, Wellsville High School golf coach, to present the Fred McGee and John Baldwin Memorial Scholarship.
My wife's class 85, does that count? Congratulations, seniors. As a parent, I've been here twice. It's an honor to have your children receive these. On behalf of the Morrison Hayes Post 702 Legion, and Sons of the American Legion, I am proud to present the Fred McGee and John Baldwin Memorial Scholarship. Fred and John were both avid golfers and devoted members of the American Legion. This scholarship is awarded to a Wellesley High School graduating senior who was also a member of the golf team. I am going to present a check for $1,000 to Mike Walsh.
Please welcome Mrs. Janet Marble, American Legion Post 702 Auxiliary.
Good evening. Congratulations to the graduates of 2016 from Wellesley High School. On behalf of the Wellesley American Legion Post 702, I'm proud to be here to award our American Legion Auxiliary Scholarship. Over the past 10 years, we've given out over $90,000 to local students going to school. Among other things, academic achievement, community service, and a strong sense of patriotism weigh heavily on our choices. Tonight's scholarship recipients have proven to our committee that they are worthy and deserving of these awards. I'd like to invite to the stage Sarah Denhop, Austin Crocker, Taylor Costello, and Kenny White. It's my honor to present each of you with an auxiliary scholarship. I want to thank you for the time that you've donated to our post. We ask as you continue your academic paths that you remain true to yourselves, to your families, and to your country. While we understand your college careers will take much of your time in the future, please remember you always have a home with your Wellesley American Legion family. Thank you.
The James D. Washburn Memorial Scholarship will be presented this evening by Mrs. Elva Cornell, Mr. Washburn's cousin.
I'm not going to tell you what year I graduated, but I am going to tell you that I started school in this system in 1955. You do the math. Congratulations, the class of 2016, but equally, congratulations, Mom and Dad. You've done a great job. May God bless each of you and your families. This scholarship was established in memory of James Washburn by his family. Jim crossed the stage and received his diploma 60 years ago this month. He was an average student. He was well-liked by both his peers and teachers. Jim loved life and laughed very quickly. He was certainly not afraid of hard work, and he enjoyed the fruits of his labors. He was a man of integrity and a great encourager. Jim was always willing to teach others things he knew, whether it be farming or how to properly swing a golf club. He never lost the desire to learn new things and put them into practice. And because of this, the family determined that the recipient of this scholarship should be a student bound for either a vocational or a technical college, someone who is deserving, well-liked, and hardworking. This year's recipient is Austin Crump.
Mrs. Marty Fuller of the Wellsville Ladies Golf Association will present Ladies Golf Association and Wellsville Country Club Awards.
Welcome, everyone. I'd like to say I was in the class of 78, but I don't think anybody will believe it. Close. We are very fortunate that this year we can present both graduating girls and graduating boys to receive our $1,000 scholarship, which is receivable on their second semester of college. And this year we have five $1,000 scholarships, which will go to Austin Crawford, the guy in the school colors I noticed, Liam Ebert, Dylan Griffiths, Brittany Jones, and finally, Emily Willard. Congratulations to everyone. Good job.
Please welcome Mrs. Linda Weshey, Altar and Rosary Society President of the Immaculate Conception Church.
Finally, it took me longer to get up here than it would take to present these scholarships. On behalf of the Alden Rotary Society, it is my privilege and honor to be able to present a scholarship to Caitlin Whitfield and Elizabeth Cole.
And please welcome Mr. Gary Peterson, Elks Scholarship Chairman for the Elks Lodge.
Good evening. On behalf of the Wellsville Lodge 1495 Scholarship Committee and all members of our lodge, we would like to recognize the entire Wellsville senior class of 2016 for your academic achievements and wish you success in your future endeavors. This year, the Wellsville Elks Lodge received and judged 16 scholarship applications throughout Allegheny County. And I'm proud to announce cumulative Elks state and local lodge scholarships in excess of $22,000. Recognizing 16 graduating seniors in this throughout Allegheny County, also recognizing 6 past recipients as well. So for all of you that do receive awards tonight from the state, make sure you keep your emails active and make sure you get those repeat scholarships in. So it's worth that effort too. So not only this year, but in past years. So so our committee looks forward to for the opportunity to judge these scholarships and look forward to their academic achievements. And it's our way of getting to see some of the some of the goals and the aspirations that these applicants have. So it's extremely impressive. So first tonight, I'd like to recognize the following Wellsville students. If you just stand initially, who advanced through lodge, district, and state judging, and recently received notifications that they would receive $1,000 scholarship awards from the New York State Elks Association. They are Rayanna Anderson, Bridget Chrisman, Leah Chrisman, Liam Ebert, Dylan Griffiths, John Piscatella. Don't let the chairs get too warm, though, okay? So tonight, on behalf of our scholarship committee and the members, I am honored to present 7 F. and Emma Jones Local Wellsville Lodge Scholarship Awards, totaling over $7,200 tonight. And those awards go to Rayanna Anderson, Bridget Chrisman, your sister Leah Chrisman, Liz Cole, Liam Ebert, Dylan Griffiths, and John Piscatella.
Industries Foundation Scholarship is presented this evening by Mr. Tom Shoup, Engineering Manager, Lufkin Industries.
Good evening. Since 1965, Lufkin Industries Foundation has awarded over $7.7 million in scholarships to qualifying dependent children of Lufkin Industries employees. Scholarships being awarded this year total $147,000. The scholarships are funded through concessions in the facilities, sale of scrap material in the factories, and memorial donations. Current four-year scholarships are valued at $8,000, payable at $1,000 per semester for four-year students. On behalf of the Lufkin Foundation, I would like to award four-year scholarship in the amount of $8,000 to Gary Havens.
The A. Edward and Evelyn R. Foster Memorial Scholarship is presented this evening by Mrs. Darlene Knox Wiley, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Foster.
Congratulations to all class of 2016. This is the 24th scholarship that I have stood before senior class to give out our scholarship to. I want to congratulate all the seniors this year. You have an incredible amount of smart children sitting in this audience tonight. 24 years ago, I lost my father very suddenly with a heart attack in the end of January. So wanting to keep my dad's name alive and the person that he stood for and what he stood for, I decided to give out a scholarship. So in talking about it, my brother said, well, I'll go in with you too, sis, because I think it's a really good idea. So therefore, the scholarship was born. My father had a real love for his family, the land, and for God. He was a really, really very hard worker. He enjoyed watching seeds grow when they were planted. He enjoyed watching his family grow. He enjoyed hunting and fishing. It was important to him to keep the land, the water, and the air clean for next generations. I lost my mother 14 years ago, so there she became part of the scholarship also, and education was very important to her. I am deeply honored to give this year's scholarship to my granddaughter, Kristen Newglin.
Please welcome to the podium Mr. Charles Joyce, President of Otis Eastern.
This scholarship probably has the longest name of any scholarship. It's awarded by the International Union of Operating Engineers and Pipeline Employers National Training Fund. And its purpose is to attract young people to the construction trades. The International Union of Operating Engineers has 500,000 members in the US and Canada. And the contractor side of it are people like Otis Eastern, Caterpillar, people around the country that build things. And we recognize that construction is not the fanciest, the most attractive business to be in anymore. So we need good young people. So we've been able to partner with Alfred State because they have two of the top programs in the country in construction. That's the diesel mechanics program and also the construction operating equipment program. So we have given out probably 50 scholarships. These are full two-year scholarships that pay 100% of the expenses for the student tuition, room board, books, the works. But after that, they're expected to win the construction business. And it's turned out quite well. This year, we're going to give out 6 scholarships in Allegheny County. And usually, it's about 5 or 6 every year. But this year's winner is Paul McCormick.
Wellsville Lions Club Scholarships and the Lions Club Medals for Excellence will be presented this evening by Mr. Michael Raptus.
Good evening, everybody. The Wellsville Lions Club has been around for over 70 years. A couple more years will be 75. And it's a community-based organization that wishes to always give back to the community. Over those years, the last 72 years, we've contributed back over $1 million back to the community. And we're very proud of that. And it also takes the community to help us out. And our fundraisers, Fishing Derby, the Minstrel Show, things of that nature, whatever comes about. That's what helps support our organization and scholarships. Some of the things we do, highway cleanup, diabetes awareness, Camp Badger, the Christmas trees that you see on the library lawn, and we're also requested many countless times for donations for multiple reasons. Another organization underneath our wing is the Leo Club. It's a high school group here Mr. Foster's a part of. They also help us out for the Minstrel Show and our activities, and we'd like you to encourage your siblings to join the Leo Club, and after you graduate from college, possibly you'll consider joining the Lions Club wherever you might go. Tonight I'm here on behalf of the Lions Club to present the 2016 scholarship winners and present the Lions Club Medals of Excellence in a particular subject. I believe that the Lions Club has been giving these scholarships out since 1982. The Medals of Excellence since 1992. By the way, I'm a class of 1980. This year, due to the death of a past member of the Lions Club, Mr. Charlie Wildman, we were able to give out a couple more scholarships thanks to his family's contribution. Now for the winners, the recipients of the Lions Club $2,000 scholarship awards are Emily Willard and Grace Irwin. Recipients of the $1,000 scholarships are Malik Ritter, Riley Hoffman, Leah Chrisman, and Elizabeth Cole. now for the recipients of the Wellsville Lions Club Medals of Excellence in a particular subject. In art, Rebecca Stevens. Business, Jennifer Domzalski. In English, Leah Crispin. Science, Danielle Guilford. In social studies, Bryce Davis. Spanish, Luke Seely. I'd like to thank you all for attending tonight's scholarship evening. And remember, we're all here to serve. Thank you.
Please welcome Mr. David Foster, our Leo's Club advisor for the high school.
Good evening. Leo's Club is Lions Club Youth Affiliate, and each year we try and offer at least one scholarship to a senior who exemplifies the motto of both the Leo's and the Lions Club, we serve. This year's recipient is Danielle Guilford.
Continuation of the awards with the Lions Club and the Leo's Club is the Lioness Club of Wellsville Scholarship. The Lioness Club honors college-bound graduates who have shown good scholarship and spirit, and this year's winner is Amy Lorschbach. Elementary PTA scholarships. The Wellsville PTA awards seniors who have given at least 50 plus hours of community service during their high school years. This year's recipients are Joshua Cook, Taylor Costello, Leah Crispin, and Christina Bill.
Wellsville Area Chamber of Commerce Calborn Allen Award is presented this evening by Mr. Brian Perkins of the Wellsville Area Chamber of Commerce.
On behalf of the Wellsville Area Chamber of Commerce, its board members, and 224 members of the organization, I'd like to congratulate all of the 2016 graduates and especially the award winners tonight. This award typically goes to someone I think who demonstrates a commitment to the community through service, and this year's recipient, I'm sure, has been dragged along, I mean, voluntarily gone along and helped out at several chamber events. And the recipient is Elizabeth Cole.
Please welcome Mr. Frank Prinzi, National Honor Society Advisor for the high school.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations to the class of 2016. This is a great evening. It is my distinct honor and privilege to serve as faculty advisor for the National Honor Society here in Wellsville. Since 1922, NHS has served to recognize both academic achievements and community service efforts of its members. In a very tangible way, NHS connects the mind and the heart, using the academic prowess of the students with the desire and willingness to look outward from self to the community, lending a hand, being a resource, easing a burden. As someone once said, selflessness is the greatest thing one can do for oneself. This year, the club logged over 700 hours of community service, while each member met the rigorous 93% grade point average required for membership. Each year, the high school chapter of the National Honor Society awards a scholarship to the student who consistently exhibited a commitment to academics, leadership, character, and service over the 2 years of membership as a junior and a senior. This year's winner is an intelligent, diligent, and affable student. She has a peaceful demeanor and an inner spirit that is marked with the positive zeal that is evident in all her pursuits. Whether she is completing an academic assignment or doing community service, this year's selection puts forth all of her effort in a positive, creative, and effective way. It is my honor and privilege to present the Wellsville Chapter's National Honor Society Scholarship to Christina Good.
Please welcome Mr. Art Van Tine from the Rotary Club of Wellsville.
Students getting these awards. But as these awards are being handed out, we have four who are getting awards. I was reading some of my notes here, and I noticed that the Wellsville Rotary Education Fund is empty. We have no money. We gave it all away. Nobody's wondering what happened there. Well, I was. Right on the next page, I nicely typed that we have now joined with the Allegheny Area Foundation. So we did give the money away. We gave it away to them. And we're working with them now, and it's going to be quite a different thing. But we have, this will be the first time that we've had student awardees with the Allegheny Area Foundation. We look for a long-term activity with them. I'm going to get lots of my own stuff here. I don't type very well. The Allegheny County Area Foundation is tonight making the awards with money that we gave them, and we will continue to do this as time goes on. All of the assets of the Rotary Education Fund have been assigned to them to work with. But this is one of the better things about this. I think that in the future, with a much bigger asset base, our asset base is $60,000. The Allegheny Foundation is $8 million. So I think with a bigger asset base and also covering the whole county, we will have the potential to possibly increase the amount that they give and also to give it to more students. In other words, they get wider dispersion than just Wellsville. But the difficulties of working with this kind of thing are horrendous. You may wonder why we did this. The IRS is getting more and more difficult. The more good things you do, the more they want to shut you down. And it's just difficult to work with them. And we get fined every year, and then we get the money back, and it's ridiculous. In closing this, I'd like to say that it's been a great pleasure for me to pick our awardees, help to pick our awardees each year. There are always many more worthy awardees than we can fund. And each year I enjoy meeting our newest awardees and talking with them at a Rotary Club luncheon. Here I want to add a big pat on the back for the parents and families of these young students, all of you who have brought them up. You are the persons who, with your love and encouragement, have helped to make it possible for these awardees to thrive and reach for the stars. Thank you, family. Thank you very much. And now I would like to give away, there is some money here, I hope, Austin Crawford. I think I've seen Austin up here quite regularly. Christina Good. $300,000 out in the past just through our own fund, and that covered 200 or 300 students. Sometimes the amount wasn't all that great, other times better, depending on what the stock market did. So we won't be dependent upon that anymore. So I think we're making it a good deal. Look forward to seeing you again next year. Thank you.
Every year, so that everyone you need them, all of the help that you need, all of that. They're terrific people who work for our school. I'm
to follow. Okay, the next award is the Kevin Lynch Memorial Scholarship. This scholarship is given by Kevin's friends and family to aid a female and male athletic college-bound senior who have achieved strong grades. This year's recipients are Michael Giopoulos and Peyton Kai. The next scholarship is the Wellsville Central School District Transportation Department Scholarship. The WCSD Transportation Department offers a scholarship to a senior planning to attend a technical or a vocational school, and this year's recipient is Austin Crawford.
Wellsville High School School Principal Award is presented this evening to a student who has had a positive influence on our school climate. The recipient this evening is Austin Winans. The Wellsville High School Principal Special Recognition Award is presented this evening to a student who demonstrates courage, determination, and perseverance. The Lions Club generously contributes to this award. It's my pleasure this evening to present this to Eric Ellis. The Monica M. Moore Memorial Scholarship is presented this evening by Robert and Hope Moore, Ms. Moore's nephew and niece.
Good evening. My wife Hope and I live in Williamsburg, Virginia. Probably wondering why we're here. It's a long drive. We started at 7 o'clock this morning. This year is the 12th year of the Monica M. Moore Memorial Scholarship. Monica lived in Wellsville most of her adult life. Passed away in 2004. We thought it was totally appropriate to establish a scholarship in her name at her high school, where she lived. Monica always put a premium on education, good manners, hard work, so we felt it was also appropriate to do this in her name. This scholarship is provided to a deserving graduating senior based on achievement of a 90% or greater cumulative GPA, has been accepted into a four-year college program, and has submitted a handwritten essay on a topic of our choice. This year's essay topic is, what do you value most at this stage of your life? Without fail, each year's essays give us a glimpse into the hearts and minds of the student writers. This year is no different. We are always impressed by how well-grounded and mature the applicants are. Selecting winners is always difficult. This year was again very difficult. We are delighted to award a $4,000 scholarship to Dylan Griffiths.
This year, Mrs. Mary Alice Moore, she's the widow of Neville Moore, Monica's only sibling, and that that is Bob's husband, Bob's father. She wanted to join in extending a scholarship because she wanted to be part of what she knows is very important for the youth. She lives in, very modestly, just outside Dallas, Texas. She's 89 years old. Most of her time is spent in a wheelchair, but she values education. She loved her time with Monica, and she wanted to be part of this. So we are pleased to extend a $1,000 scholarship provided by Mrs. Moore to Danielle Guilford.
The Lars E. Lanfer Memorial Scholarship is presented this evening by Mrs. Nancy Sope, family friend of Lars E. Lanfer.
Good evening. I'm so honored to be here to present this scholarship, the Lars Lanfer Memorial Scholarship. This is given by my son, Dr. Rick Sope, for his friend, in memory of his friend, Lars Lindeson. Rick started this scholarship several years ago. Rick and Lars are graduate of 1992. And when Rick was a senior, he was sitting where you are, and his dream was to become a doctor. And he really felt that the education and the experience that he received here in Wellsville gave him the foundation to achieve that goal. And so when he graduated from med school, he chose to give back, and he wanted to help another student. So he gives out a $1,000 scholarship to a student that's going either into medicine or one of the health sciences. When he first started the scholarship, he called it the Science of Life Scholarship. And then his buddy died. Lars and Rick met in kindergarten here in Wellsville, and they were instant buddies. They spent a lot of their childhood at each other's homes, on their vacations together, and their friendship remained throughout their school years and afterwards into their adult life. And it was forging into a lifelong relationship. Sometimes a life doesn't last very long, and when Lars passed away, Rick really struggled with that loss and wanted to do something special to honor the memory of a friendship. And so he established his scholarship and changed the name to the Lars Lanfer Scholarship. Lars had a love of writing and English and Latin, so he incorporated into his application an essay as part of the application. It's really been good because he's loved these essays and it's given him a good insight into the applicants and has helped him to choose for it. And as a parent, our children's friends become special to us too, and so Lars tugs at my heart. Before we present the scholarship tonight, Lars is going to want to say a little something to him.
Good evening. Thank you, Nancy. I'm your beloved son, Dr. Richard Sope, for honoring my son, Lars Lanfer's memory. As Lars's mother, I have attended scholarship night for a number of years, but just couldn't speak. Tonight, I shall. Lars was a 1992 graduate of Wellsville High School. Lars was also a member of the Menominee Indian Tribe of Wisconsin. When a person has died in our culture, we say he has journeyed into the spirit world. Lars's journey began May 27, 2011, at the age of 37. As a young man, following in the steps of his father, his grandfathers, and his great-grandfather, Lars dedicated 4 years to the Vermont National Guard. He proudly became a member of our veterans of the Menominee Nation, and as such was proclaimed a warrior.
It is my honor and privilege to acknowledge all the applicants for Lars's scholarship. Thank you. Forgive me. A senior moment. Well, anyway, once again, thank you, Nancy and Dr. Richard Sape, for honoring my son Lars's memory. And congratulations to all the 2006 graduates of Wellsville High School.
And we'd like to present this year's recipient to Lars's son, Ethan Landry.
Beta Sigma Pi sorority scholarship is presented this evening by Mrs. Shauna Peterson, a Beta Sigma Pi sorority member.
Beta Sigma Pi is an international organization. It was created in 1931 in Alderoon, Kansas by Walter Ross. Our organization was created for young women in search of culture and social activity. From what started as 7 members, we have grown to well over 250,000 active members and nearly 12,000 chapters. These chapters consist of Ritual Jewels, Exemplar, Preceptor, Laureate, and Master's degrees. Your local chapters are Gamma Pi, Xi Alpha Omicron, Preceptor Beta Upsilon, and Laureate Alpha Xi. Our Laureate group contains the last of our original members. Though we are not a service organization, we feel it our responsibility to give back to our community. Our chapters combine to form City Council, and together we have raised funds for these scholarships. We maintain the bench gardens at the library, and have participated in the country fair for Jones Memorial Hospital. Each of our chapters separately have also contributed to our community. We have supported the library bench gardens, Park Comfort House, the SPCA, Toys for Tots, county agencies for those affected by domestic violence, placed in foster care, or been affected by emergency or natural disasters, just to name a few. This evening, in addition to the Beta Sigma Phi scholarships, Gamma Pi chapter would like to give each of the recipients an additional $100 to help get them on their way. It is my privilege to give this year's City Council Beta Sigma Phi scholarships and Gamma Pi awards to Bryce Davis and Jonathan Piscatelli. Is given by the Air Preheater Benevolent Club to reward students for their hard work and academic excellence. This year there are 2 recipients, Elizabeth Cole and Malik Ritter. Henry and Rosa Gabriel Scholarships. These scholarships are given to reward the top two female and the top two male seniors in the class of 2016. This year's recipients are Leah Crispin, Bryce Davis, Danielle Guilford, and Luke Seely. Next scholarship this evening is the Wellsville Central School District Employees Scholarship. These scholarships are funded by employee contributions. The Alice Filkins Scholarship is awarded to a senior entering the field of education, and this year's Alice Filkins recipient is Gary Havens. The Wellsville Central School District employees also honor late teacher Pat Pickett, and this scholarship is awarded to an outstanding senior who loves English, and this year's recipient is Lauren Slavin.
Please welcome Mr. Rick Freeman, past Deputy Supreme Governor of Moose Lodge 601.
Again, I'd like to congratulate the class of 2016. This year, the Wellsville Lions will have four scholarships, two $500 and two $250 ones. First will be the Cassandra Condon Memorial Scholarship. Our committee decided to split this one, $250 each, and we're going to go with Bridget Crispin and Leah Crispin. Jim Scott for Memorial, he's a past governor. This goes to Austin Crawford. Scholarship award goes to Sarah Denhoff.
Please welcome Ms. Tammy Ives, Senior Regent from the Women of the Moose.
First, I'd like to congratulate the class of 2016. I'm a proud parent of one of the seniors. The Women of the Moose base our scholarship on community service, respect, honesty, and determination. The first scholarship from the Women of the Moose for $300 will be rewarded to Joelle Nunziato. Our second scholarship is a member of Gwilda Carberry. This scholarship is $700 and will be rewarded to Joshua Cook.
The Jonathan Slauson Memorial Scholarship is presented this evening by Mrs. Kimberly Slauson, Jonathan's mother.
Good evening. Congratulations, students. I am here tonight to give the Jonathan Slauson Memorial Scholarship Award to help further one young man's education. This memorial scholarship is collected from friends, family of Jonathan, and loved ones of Jonathan Slauson that was a 19-year-old when he was 19 years old when he passed away in January 2015. Jonathan went to this school his whole life. Jonathan enjoyed wrestling and football for a short time in his middle school years. He then loved to hunt, fish, camp, and spend time with his family. Jonathan was working on his next steps in life just before he passed away. He was enlisted in the U.S. Navy and ready to leave in just eight short weeks before his passing. He wanted so much to work in law enforcement or conservation after he served in the U.S. Navy. And for this, Jonathan's father, brother, friends, and family want to give this memorial scholarship in memory of our loved one, Jonathan Slauson, to Terrence Potter, as he enjoys many of the same things our son, Jonathan Slauson, did. We hope this will help Terrence with his college education. Thank you all, and good luck to all the students.
Please welcome Mr. Travis Midoff, Wellsville Sea Lions Booster Club President.
This year, three amazing girls are going to share our scholarship. So, as you hear your names, please come to the front. Two of our girls are longtime veterans that have shared our captain spot on our team since their sophomore year. For the past 6 years, no one could mention Wellsville swimming in this town without thinking of Sarah and Rebecca Stevens. Moving forward, Sarah plans to attend Cazenovia College and study interior design. Rebecca has chosen Alfred State and intends to study liberal arts. Our third girl is a member of the National Honor Society and a one-of-a-kind young lady. Christina Good is a four-year veteran, a captain, who just so happens to be one of my daughter's close friends. A message written by her teammates shed the light on the things this young woman has brought to her team we as a community may not have noticed. And I quote, "Her guidance, strong work ethic, and kind heart have bonded her with most of our young swimmers forever. Girls, we will miss you this fall, so with a heavy heart, a hopeful eye, and a helping hand, I'd like to present the scholarship to you as you leave our pool forever and move forward in life. Good luck."
the Wellsville High School Music Service Scholarships are presented this evening by Mr. Cody Hampton and Ms. Kathy Haynes.
Here to honor a few outstanding music students from the class of 2016, the Music Boosters have generously contributed to the following awards. The National School Choral Award is the highest honor for a high school choral performer. It recognizes dedication, musical achievement, and leadership. The selected student for this award has been a true asset to the vocal music program in Wellsville. The student is an active member of WAVE, while they competed in two international competitions, and a member of the Wellsville High School Chamber Choir through two NISMA Choral Majors experiences, including the most recent performance of a level 6 standard in which they received gold. He has participated in Solo Fest, Man Choir at Temple University, and various all counties and area all state festivals, including this year's Select Show Choir. This student has spent countless hours outside of the school day and classroom working on his theory skills and vocal ability. Consistently, I am overloaded with many tasks throughout the year. He is always volunteering to lend a hand. Whether it is copying something, creating a poster for an upcoming event, setting up or tearing down the auditorium and sound system, or arranging music, he is always there to help in a timely and professional manner. He is a true definition of a leader. It is my privilege to award the National School Choral Award to Bryce Davis. And Service Award goes to a senior member of WAVE that has given countless hours to the success of the group and consistently leads the group in a positive direction. The senior that will receive this award has been clearly invaluable. This student has been the choreographer for the past 2 years and truly tested the group's limits with her skills. Her, as well as her parents, have held many WAVE functions at their home. She consistently tries to guide the group in a positive and team-oriented direction. The WAVE Leadership and Service Award goes to Kaylin Whitfield.
Hello. The first award I'm going to be giving out tonight is the Director's Award for Orchestra, which will be given out on behalf of Ms. Julie Robinson, our Orchestra Director. The Director's Award for Orchestra honors the top leader of a high school orchestra. The award is given for musical achievement and leadership. The selected student this year has been playing the violin since fourth grade and has been the concert mistress with the orchestra for 2 years. She has attended multiple all-county solo festival and area all-states. The student recently led the orchestra to a silver rating at NISBA Majors, an achievement that hasn't occurred in over a few decades for our orchestra. The Director's Award for Orchestra goes this year to Bridget Christmas. The John Philip Sousa Award is given to an exceptional band student who demonstrates superior musicianship, dependability, loyalty, and cooperation. This year, there were two students who have displayed all of these qualities through their participation in marching band, jazz band, as well as multiple all-county and area all-state festivals. Both of these students are integral pieces to the ensemble and have both helped lead our band to achieve a silver rating at NISBA Majors this year. I am honored to have had a chance to work with these two students, and our ensemble will greatly suffer without their exceptional leadership next year. The John Philip Sousa Award for Excellence in Band goes to Leah Christman and Luke Seeley.
Thank you very much.
Please welcome Sergeant Jonathan Burroughs of the United States Marine Corps.
Gentlemen, my name is Sergeant Burroughs. I'm your local Marine Corps representative. It gives me great pleasure to participate in your award ceremony tonight. On behalf of all Marines, I salute you on a job well done. The purpose of me being here is to recognize certain students who went above and beyond their peers in areas of musical excellence, athletic achievement, and scholastic achievement. Students, when I call your name, please come forward. The Semper Fi Dellis Award for Musical Excellence is sponsored by the United States Marine Youth Foundation, a nonprofit organization established to provide incentives for achievement in our nation's schools. The foundation has provided an award for musical excellence for student musicians throughout the country. This year's recipients are Jerrica Mess and Bryce Davis. The Athletic Achievement Award is designed to recognize high school varsity athletes who display courage, poise, self-confidence, and leadership on and off the field. They're also exemplary citizens and positive role models for younger students. Award recipients are not necessarily the best athletes, but instead are those who are the most inspirational or display the greatest determination and the will to win, which are all Marine-like attributes. This year's recipients are Liam Ebert and Amy Larsbaugh. Scholastic Achievement Award is designed to recognize noteworthy academic achievement and leadership in high school students. Nominees are exemplary young citizens and role models for their peers. Recipients need not necessarily be a straight-A student, but students who have shown the greatest degree of academic improvement over the past semester or year. This year's recipients are Luke Seeley and Riley Hoffman. I'd also like to recognize one of your fellow classmates who has made the decision to serve our country as a United States Marine. As I call your name, please stand as I read the contents of your award. This is to certify that Christopher Domzowski has successfully passed the required mental, moral, and physical examinations and has been accepted for enlistment into the delayed entry program of the United States Marine Corps. The defense of our country and our freedoms is the duty and privilege of every citizen. The Marine Corps has a proud tradition of outstanding service to our country in peace and war. Voluntary membership in this elite military organization is a clear demonstration of the American qualities of patriotism and loyalty. Anyone who has served in our armed forces, to include all first responders. If you can, at this time, please stand, and ladies and gentlemen, join me in the salute to these heroes. Crossing, Sip Fidelis, and God bless the United States of America. Sandra L. Dilley Memorial Scholarship. This scholarship is given to a senior who will be going on to college to pursue a career in teaching and education, and this year's recipient is Gary Havens. The Elizabeth Walkley Memorial Scholarship. The Walkley family gives this scholarship to WHS seniors achieve their dreams with the stipulation that the winners exhibit kindness, empathy, and respect for others. This year's recipients of the Elizabeth Walkley Memorial Scholarship are Cooper Buckley, Haley Cook, Garrett Martin, Riley Hoffman, and Jonathan Piscatelli. The next scholarship is the UFCW Local 1 Benefit Fund Scholarship. The United Food and Commercial Workers, District Union, Local 1, and Tops Markets are pleased to partner in funding and granting scholarships. To receive the scholarship, the following criteria was considered: GPA, essay content, school and community activities, financial need, and unusual circumstances, and timeliness. This year, they are awarding over 600 scholarships totaling $700,000. High school seniors will receive a $1,000 scholarship. Since inception, over 20,000 scholarships have been awarded, equating to nearly $20 million. Tonight, they are happy to announce the following 2016 scholarship recipient, Tyler Anderson. Bartholomew Nursing Scholarship. Mrs. Bartholomew gave the proceeds from the sale of her home to help graduates earn an RN degree. And this year's recipients of the Bartholomew Nursing Scholarship are Elena Grassdorf and Peyton Kide. Since 1956, the will of Mrs. Darnow has provided awards to encourage college study. This year's recipients of the Darnow Memorial Scholarship are Joshua Cook and Daniel Fuller.
The Wellsville High School Students Against Destructive Decisions Scholarship is presented this evening to Danielle Guilford. The VFW Post 2530 Mike Pasquale Scholarship is presented this evening to two students to reward their good scholarship and patriotism. Please come up front with Austin Crawford and Gary Havens. The Dolores Neary Anstead Scholarship. Carol W. Anstead, the first vice president of Smith Barney Incorporated, Olean, has set up this generous fund to help Wellsville High School graduates. Recipients this evening are Darcy Brownell and Joelle Nunziato. Please welcome to the stage at this time Ms. Heather Garish to present the Wellsville Business and Professional Women's Club Scholarship.
This evening I'm representing the WPBW, I never get those initials quite right, but we spend the year raising funds both to support the efforts of the Wellsville Jones Memorial Auxiliary and also our scholarship fund. We wish that we had made more money this year so that we would be able to award more students, all deserving. But this year's, we've got three recipients, Rihanna Anderson, Elizabeth Cole, and Danielle Guilford.
The M.A. King and Eleanor Church King Memorial Scholarship is awarded this evening to a senior entering the field of engineering or education. The recipient this evening is Marissa Clausen.
Civil Service Employees Association Scholarship. The Wellsville Central School District CSEA Chapter 802 honors children of members, and this year's recipients are Rihanna Anderson and Danielle Guilford. This year's Joshua G. Giddings Memorial Scholarship is given in memory of Joshua G. Giddings, a class of 2003 graduate, and this year's recipient is Jacob Siever. David Song Scholarships. This gift from Miss Audrey Phelps Coffey, class of 1956, is awarded to graduates who are eager to learn and to grow. This year's recipients are Callie Laniger and Peyton Lau. The District No. 6 Federal Credit Union Award Liam Ebert is chosen for this award. This award is chosen from 30 entries. The criterion is that the student, parent, or grandparent is a member of the credit union. One of them must fill out an entry form, and during their annual meeting, names are drawn. The student that is drawn must be going on to further their education. District number 6 credit union would like to congratulate Liam and wish him the best in his future endeavors. The recipients have already received their actual scholarship at a meeting earlier tonight, but I would like to recognize you and please stand. The International Association of Aerospace Workers, the Machinist Union, Local 1580, has awarded Peyton Kai a $250 scholarship and also Austin Winans a $250 local scholarship. Peyton Kai was also selected of 1 out of 4 in New York State by the Council of Machinists for an additional $500 scholarship. And they were already awarded this evening, but please stand in recognition. The New York State Senate Youth Leadership Recognition Award. The New York State Senate honors outstanding students who will become our future leaders. The program recognizes local students who excel in academics and in extracurricular activities and volunteer activities. And this year's recipient is Danielle Guilford.
Please welcome Mr. Jim Knapp, Senior Vice President of Steuben Trust.
Good evening. Each year, Steuben Trust Company awards 5 students from across Western New York who are going to a business field and have shown academic excellence, good citizenship, and volunteerism, a $5,000 scholarship. This year's Allegheny County recipient is Bryce Davis.
Thank you one more time to all our presenters, the groups and organizations they represent, for their investment in students here in Wellsville. I'd also like to thank the families of our seniors for their trust and support they provided over these 4 years. We wish you the best and encourage you to continue the pursuit of excellence in all you undertake. Thank you this evening to Mr. Willard Yusher's Club, Mr. Hampton and Wade, Mr. Fontaine and his audio group, and Mr. Dennis Dahlgren for taking all the pictures that you'll soon see on our website. Before we go out and enjoy some punch and cookies in the atrium, apparently we found a couple of sets of keys. So if anybody lost keys out on the landing on the stairs or in the bathroom, we have those. Please come and grab them from us. Other than that, please enjoy your evening. Thank you for coming and drive safely. Thank you.